What's up, fellow YouTubers? How's it going for you today? My name is Darth Tom, your humble and lovable Sith Lord. Back to do some more Fallout New Vegas. Last time we left off, we were doing some more stuff with Fallout's Chalk, as well as pretty much getting absolutely destroyed by a freaking giant-ass Cazador, which was pretty much the first time that I would ever actually witness a... First time I ever witnessed a Cazador this early in the game. Which was always a fun little surprise. And pretty much today we're going to be relatively continuing on with this game here. Finding out what lovable goodies we can find here. I actually did turn down the difficulty pretty much down to very easy because pretty much the AI is very, very difficult to kill. And I really don't have a whole lot of stim packs to work with, and since the whole healing over time thing is kind of a pain in the ass to do, I'm pretty much just gonna say screw it. I'm just gonna go with very easy and just hopefully find a bed. Hopefully find a bed here. And there's a hollowed out rock there. Log. Not a rock. Ooh, wow, it's a maze. It's amazing that I can actually find anything in there. And yeah, that pun was kind of corny. But I'm just, I just like giving people an earful. Beats me. I don't think there's anything really is over there. I need to really grab. I thought there would be like a door somewhere to, like, here, but guess not. Guess it's just there for aesthetics. But pretty much the game plan for the immediate future is to eventually try to finish up with this DLC, which I will admit I've done quite a bit of exploring here that probably I shouldn't really do more of, but hey, it's my playthrough. Pretty much I decide what to do with it, and I don't know what's up with that, but I would have swore I didn't kill anything that would warrant that perk to come up, but I guess I missed that. Pull up the car. No. Pull up you up. No. Alright. I guess not. Bummer. Well, I guess we can now go over to where we were supposed to be at a little bit ago. Come on, die, dog. You gonna do anything there, bud? There, guy.
Perhaps you might find peace if you stay.
That's the reason why he didn't really attack me as much as he could have. Maybe he has just a shotgun, really. And a sledgehammer. Yeah, I'm fairly certain I'm gonna regret this, but I do have quite a few needs here that I can use here. Some explosives. That'll at least somewhat help me out. If there is actually a god, there won't be any cazadores very much around here. I won't have to die and kill. You are pretty much almost incapacitated. No, I don't want to kill you. Headshot, there we go. Sweet. God, those fire axes are so annoying. They're just pieces of work. Not the most fun. Ow. Yeah, here. Wow, I only hit him twice. Alright, thank you. I'm almost halfway over to level 18. That was the one that I was looking at. Had before. Holy frag mines. He has a lot. We'll actually use the incinerator. Let's see here. Right there. Make this a little bit easier. Burn. Burn so that. No. Holy shit. At first I thought that was a freaking cazador. Try to freaking scare me, game. I mean, Cazador is, even in their freaking small form, is such annoying as freaking hell. And starting a little bit of battery. Giving me that old flashy light thing. The home button. Can't grab anything from that. Alright. Should. Oops. Stay over that. Mosey along. Here. I'm gonna steal over your game. Oh, you. There we go. I haven't really worthy. But pretty much I got it anyway. Alright, let's find this up here. Nothing. Oh, I see it. Bye bye. Affleck is better. Which isn't really saying much. gecko. Some food. Really need to go visit Doc again. Good doctor. Back in Good Springs. Get my freaking radiation level down. Burn. Die. Sorry already. Oh, holy shit. Oh my god. I am almost dead. There we go. Take care of you. Not about that. It's like everywhere I turn, pretty much people want to kill me. People didn't really make it out here alive. Really should keep an eye on my freaking health. Even though I'm pretty much in the lowest freaking difficulty ever. Side. God damn. Bear traps. Stupid bear traps. Well, that pretty much means only probably one thing, pretty much where we're very, very close to where we definitely need to be. Let's see, where are the objectives again? Let's see, wipe out the White Leg encampments in Bighorn Bluff. Steal all the White Leg support totems and camps. Sorry. That's right, you have to take down their totems first and then deal with them. Pretty much their totems really give them pride and stuff. I think your fearless leader and the other fearless leader exactly see the eye to eye. Pretty much the Burn Man. Burn Man pretty much believes in what he wants. Holy shit. Ah, shit. Alright, looks like it's just a... gecko.
I'll fight you if I must.
And a young gecko. What the shit? Die. What the? Finally. Goddamn freaking Yagwai. Alright, so. So there is a big corner. Much as I said before earlier in the playthrough, they don't really. They won't attack you unless you pretty much invade their territory. But just essentially leave them alone and they will leave you alone. And so there's food. What you're saying. Nor do I really care. There we go. Down below. There we go. Oh, that did absolutely nothing. Here. Need some more food. Where are you? Anywhere. And bye-bye. Goodbye to you. Alright. Bring you out. Didn't take falling damage from there. Alright. I've got here. Let's we'll take that. Stuff here. Special. Has a little egg. Yummy.
Those tents down there, that is a White Leg war camp. Do you see the war totems they've erected around the tents? White Leg warriors pray to them for strength and savagery before battle. This is no raiding band. Yes, if their war totems were to disappear, they would likely lose the will to fight. You might rush them and take them by surprise. We would be badly outnumbered then, though, and these will be strong fighters. We might also use their superstition against them. White Leg warriors believe that to lose their totems on the eve of battle is a terrible omen. I will follow your command, but I advise caution if it is possible.
All right. So pretty much she just mentioned what we were already talking about here. So pretty much these totems here, take those down. Take those down, pass them around. Let's see here. Couple, at least one. Nope, that's just freaking. That's just a freaking bighorner, and there's a yaogwai. And thank God, it's just a freaking cub. And good night. Yeah, we'll just go around.